Hi Ray, do you want to tell us about it?
This is a garden snake we caught in our front yard.
It feels really smooth.
Right over there next to our peach tree and maple tree. I found a coil up next to
I found it going into the coil.
Well, anyway. And then we saw it go into the coil under the tree stump of the maple tree. So we decided to catch it. We told our dad and he came. And then we caught it, and we wanted to see if it could get out. So now we're here with this garter snake.
Cool. So what are you going to do afterwards? No, Ryan, no!
We'll see what happens if we touch the underside.
The underside's more.
Ricky, and this is Daisy, the garter snake that we just caught in our yard. She is a girl, and we know this because if you look at her butt, which is this part, the tail is quite short. So that means she's a girl. If it was a lot longer, then she would be a male. Because of the stripes, and if it were not an Eastern garter snake, it might have been like more tannish colored, more sandy. And you can also tell that her scales are faintly checkered. See, it's kind of checkered-ish. And the side is green, and it's very pretty.
Alright, so where did you find it?
Well, actually, my brother found her under our deck over there.
Do you want to put it back?
Sure.
Yeah. Okay, let's say bye to her then. Bye, Daisy.
Their poop is very easy to clean up because it goes in clumps. And also, snakes might be deceiving to a few people. People might think that they're scary, except they're not as scary as they seem. Normal snakes would not bite you if you pick them up, as long as you don't purposely poke them or try to step on them or hurt them. They most likely wouldn't hurt you. They might poop a bit, but they wouldn't hurt you. But I can't guarantee that. Some snakes might bite you, except only if you provoke them. So if you really want to pick up a snake that's wild, then try to identify it first. And if you can't identify it, don't pick it up, because it could be venomous and you don't want it to bite you.